Today, I'm going to show you how you can add countdown timers onto your streams. So, the first one is Snaz. I think that's how you pronounce it, but you can find the link in the description. Now, this is the worst one, but it's a quick and easy countdown. So, once you download the app, this is what you'll be looking at. Now, you will go down to countdown to Pacific time. It is 9:34 at the moment, but this says 9:35, but you will click on this and you will change it to 5 minutes ahead. So, I'm going to click 40. Because by the time I get this done, it will be 5 minute countdown. So you will click start. And as you can see here, it is starting to count down. You will go over here and copy. You will go over to your StreamLabs and you will click add source. You will go to text and you will add it as a source. You can name it the countdown if you want, but you'll add a source. You will come down here from read from file and click it. Now you will paste in. This is your timer. As soon as you come up, you will see it. Click Control Alt and get rid of the first two numbers. And there you have it. A nice easy countdown. So that is a very quick and easy countdown, but can be very annoying because every time you want a countdown, you'll have to open the app back up and change the settings again. So according to YouTube's analytics, only a small amount of you guys are actually subscribed to this channel. So if you end up liking this video, consider subscribing. Thank you. The next countdown will be the easiest one to get and is on a website called StreamDPS. This is the website that you can find it in the description. You will go down and you can pick whatever countdown you want. So let's pick this one. So once you're in it, just scroll down and here's all your settings. Now after you customize your settings, just click apply and scroll down until you see open in browser. Now copy it. Go to StreamLabs and click add source. Go to browser source. Add a source. You can name it the countdown, but add a source. Now change the URL into the one that you just copied. Your countdown will appear. Now that is the easiest way to get a countdown, and there's tons of different designs, almost 5 pages. Last countdown is in Stream Elements. You'll need to make an account, but the account is free. Once in Stream Elements, you need to go onto the side, go to Streaming Tools, go to My Overlays, and create new overlay. Once in here, make sure it's 1080p and click start. Add a widget, go to engagement, and go to countdown. Right here is the time. You can change it to whatever you want. I'm going to say 5 minutes. And you can see it right here. Now there's a bunch of settings you can do, like the position, style, size, whatever, how big you want it. You can change it all. After when you change it all to your liking, just click save and name it whatever you want. Now go up here and copy overlay URL. Go back to OBS StreamLabs and click add source. Go to browser source and add a source. Name it once again to countdown, add source. Go to the URL and paste it into the URL and click close. You need to click Control Alt to get rid of the first two zeros. Now, of course, with the Stream Elements one, you can make that look insanely good. You just need to spend time on the settings. That was just a quick example on how to get a countdown. That's why it was so small and looking like unprofessional. But if you spend time on it, you can make it look really good. And that is 3 different ways to get a countdown onto your streams. If you like the video, make sure you click the thumbs up and subscribe for more.